Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft on the LumpiaCraft server. And I have found myself in a little bit of a predicament. I still have been experiencing some great deals of internet lag on my part of the house at the moment, and I haven't gotten it fixed yet. I'm still working on it, but I was playing Minecraft. I was at my base in Atlantis, and I went through the nether portal. And then I got kicked off, I got timed out, and I signed back in, and I had somehow gotten teleported to this far away. I actually don't know exactly how far away from my portal I am, but I'll put a screenshot on right now showing you what I saw when I signed back in. I was nowhere near a portal, and I was almost literally on the brink of death. I have no idea if I've been to this, this fortress yet. Slightly scared for my life, but I'm going to try to find my way back, and then we'll get on with the rest of the episode. That is the dead end. And I have something very special planned for today. I have recently been working a lot on both the end portal room and my base on Atlantis, which is why I was there. And I will show you the progress I have made on those at a later episode. For today, I planned on, let's see if I've been here before. I have not. Man, I must be very far. Alright, so I guess I'm going to explore this place really quick. Make sure that I can get whatever good stuff I want. And then, you guys may have noticed that Unlimited Lumpia has been a little bit of a ghost on the server. He hasn't really been on much. He's been on a little bit here and there off camera, but not nearly as much as I have. And, you know, being on the server, it gets a little lonely sometimes when no one else signs on. So we are going to give him an incentive to come back in the form of a prank. So I'm going to go ahead and check all these chests, check this fortress out, and then I will meet you guys back at Triforce. Alright guys, so we are back. What was that? Was that his guardians underneath? Yeah, it must have been. So we did get him those guys, Mario and Luigi. It looks like, oh, he put them in cobwebs, or they got stuck in cobwebs. Interesting. One way to get them to stop bouncing. But anyways, way back when, I did a mediocre prank in which I had filled his garden, whatever this is, with villagers. And it was an okay prank. You know, I had originally meant there to be a lot more villagers than I had actually put in there, and I want to do a variation of that prank today, except I want to actually fill up his entire triangle with pigmen. The trick with that is that I'm going to need a bunch of name tags, and then a bunch of, you know, pigmen, of course. So what I'm thinking is I'm going to go ahead and disable the portal in City Hall and in my base. We're going to build a new portal here, and we're going to bring in some pigmen into here. But first off, I need to make sure that the pigmen can't get out of his base. So I'm just going, you know, we're just going to line this like so, just so they can't get out, I think, right? Yeah. Yeah. So we're going to do that really quick. It looks like Unlimited Lumpia's base might have gotten hit by a little bit of lightning here. But that's okay. I don't think we're gonna do any babies on baby pigmen, I guess. I ran out of half slabs. But I don't think we're gonna do any baby pigmen. We could, if we by chance catch any, but we'll see. I did realize that I could use armor or weapons to keep the pigmen here, so I might do that too. We'll see. I don't need that many more. That should be enough. That should be more than enough, actually. So I'm gonna try to see if I can do this all in one day. I'm not sure if I will be able to. I think I can leave that open. Yeah, there we go. I think we have jump boost, don't we? Yeah, we do. Okay. That should be where they can get out this way. Technically, I guess they could jump on top of that, but I don't think they'd go anywhere else beyond that, so... Yeah, and then the problem would be we have to fill all of this up, which is going to be insane. I don't want them to go down here, so I'm going to go ahead and block this off. Oh, trying not to ruin the vines he has going. Or, I think I put those, but... you know, whatever. And then... we can close this door. Do pigmen open doors? I don't remember. I think this is... what is all this? Stuff. That's fine that they wander in there. So I said we're gonna need a lot of pigmen for this project. so... Let's see what we can go ahead and do. I'm gonna try to get maybe... 2 stacks of name tags, I'm thinking. So, and then I need to go ahead and break those and whatnot. So, a lot of work. Let's see if I can do all this within today's timing recording session. Alright guys, so I got 30 name tags so far, which is not bad. I did not expect them to get them all in one go. I mean, these things are 20 emeralds each, so I knew it was gonna take a while. What I'm gonna do now, I've run out of sugarcane, so I was using that to get my emeralds with the paper. So while that replenishes itself, because I have 2 farms going. I know Unlimited Lupia has 1 farm going in his little secret area. Whoopsie, I'll replace that, sorry. He has 1 farm going. So I figured as I'm bringing the pigmen over, the sugarcane farms will continue running and we can continue getting those. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and build the portal here. Just trying to figure out a good place to do it. I want to do it so that the pigmen can come in even while I'm doing like trading and whatnot. They can come in and I can just tag them or try to give them a piece of armor or something and then make it so they can't leave again. So I'm thinking we're just gonna put it like a block higher, that way they can walk off and whatnot, but they can't get back in. But I need... oh, whatever. We'll put it here. And then I really should bring some garbage blocks with me. I'm gonna take that for now. Okay. There we go. We'll put that there. Okay. Hope I brought enough blocks. I made this too wide anyways, didn't I? Doo-doo-doo. Thank you. Yeah, you can see the lag that I'm getting right now. Principally right now it's also because of the rain. But... pain in my butt, guys. Where'd it go? There it is. Have it. Oh my god! This lag. Really? Okay. And now we just need a flint and steel and we can start getting some mobs in here. And of course I didn't bring a flint steel with me, so let me go grab one. Alright guys, so I have 6 shulker boxes here full of leather armor. Most of it's enchanted. Not all of it, but most of it. I used leather just because the gold armor I can smelt down to gold nuggets if I ever need to. The leather armor I don't see myself ever needing to use. So we have that, and then I have another shulker box here that has a bunch of minecarts and rail. So we're probably gonna use that. I haven't seen any pigmen come through since I built the portal, so we're gonna go ahead and go through and see if we can send some through. We do have the problem that our nether portal thingy in the nether is actually made, like, pigmen don't actually spawn inside the middle of it, so we'll see if I can get some pigmen in there without having to aggro them. I really don't want to aggro them, so what I could do is just, you know, make these spawnable for now, I guess. Thing we could do, we could just put some of this down. Alright, so guys, you are in my camera account right now, and it looks like we got our first batch of volunteers. I saw one go through already, actually, and I'm thinking maybe I should have been on the other side to make sure he stays there. I don't know. I forget what the spawn time is that they have when they go to the other side. But we're gonna push this guy through, and then we're gonna go through and check. Well, having a brief look around, I don't see nor do I hear them, so I'm guessing once they went through, they despawned, so that might mean I need to name tag and whatnot them on the other side before I do this. So, good to know. So we're gonna go- I didn't mean to do that. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and take these shulker boxes with me. Right now I'm just gonna focus on just using the armor. I'm not gonna worry too much about the name tags. For one, I haven't actually named them yet. So this is the one with all the name tags on it. So yeah. Let's go ahead, head through, and see if we can get some more. We might have a slight problem. I forgot. I don't know if you had the store here. this was his rabbit pen. And I was looking at the footage, I was like, why are all these rabbits everywhere? Yeah! Oh! I didn't realize they'd break- one, I didn't realize they'd break that door down, and then, yeah, we're gonna do some rabbit wrangling really quick. And then we'll continue, but we're not doing too badly. We have a good number. I've used maybe 2/3 of a shulker box. Maybe. So we're gonna get some carrots. I need to figure out a better way to block the door. I think I have some iron doors somewhere. Or I could use trap doors. Either way, I have to go and wrangle these rabbits really quick. And maybe pick up some more food. Big mistake. If you can't see that, there is currently a gas wand inside of our nether portal hub. That's not good. It's very interesting. It'd be fun to name tag him, but not really, no. Otherwise, I have made a portal down here just because there is a bigger area for me to catch pigmen down here than up there, which is probably why the gas spawned in there in the first place. But I just want to show you guys that, because it's funny, and if the guys knew, they'd probably kill me. Yeah. Another half of a shulker box, So, given that I've done six, by the end of this, hopefully I will have done six shulker boxes and 32 name tags, I don't think I'm gonna do the other name tags just because it's actually taking a lot longer. Oh my god, this is annoying. It's taking a lot longer for the sugarcane and the zombie meat to produce so that I can get emeralds. So, we're probably not gonna do that anymore. And it will save on resources anyways, so it's probably a good thing. There we go. Okay. So what we are going to do is we are going to finish this up. It is getting pretty late for me. I have been at this now. I started at around 2 p.m. It is almost 1 a.m. at the moment. So it's been a while. That being said, once I finish all the pigmen, I'm not quite done with this prank yet. And I'm looking at the Olympia's base in my other account right now, and it is actually looking pretty good. Like, just seeing the little pinks wander around, I'm really excited about this. I know Olympia is probably gonna freak out a little bit, and that's exactly what we want. But we want to do one more piece of this prank, and so I'm gonna have to hurry up and finish this. I'm hoping it only take me about another half an hour, and then we will go ahead and do the last little bit of it that I think will be kind of fun and just kind of tops it all off. So just to add a little bit more pink, I've decided that every once in a while I'll come over here and breed some pigs up. So that will be a thing. The pigs will add to the pinkness, but this is actually looking really good. It's not, you know, you're never going to have a full base this size be completely filled with pigmen. But the fact that we're going to have pretty much 200 pigmen in here is pretty crazy. My one problem is all of them. I don't know what they're trying to get to, but all the pigmen seem to be going to that one corner, and I don't know why. If anybody knows what they could possibly be going towards, please let me know, because I don't understand. So yeah, it's weird, and if I open this door, more just go in, so that's how I ended up with so many in there in the first place. So, yeah, I don't know what's going on. Unless they're trying to attack the bunnies, because all the bunnies are in that corner too now. I don't know. So, guys, it's not quite a complete replica, but I think you get the point. It looks kind of funny with his wood fence thing sticking up, but we are pretty much done. We didn't get 100% of the pigmen we wanted, but that is okay by me. This took a really long time. It is approaching 2 a.m. right now, and I am beat, and I am going to go to bed. But I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. What happens if a pigman gets hit by a lightning bolt? I know if a pig gets hit by one, it turns into a pigman. Anyways, as I said, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. I'm going to leave a message for Unlimited Lumpia, letting him know that he needs to be recording the next time he signs on, whenever that will be. And I hope he enjoys. I don't know how he's gonna get rid of these. I guess if he needs help, I can help him. But ooh, we need to take this down, don't we? That is a thing. And we need to go and light up the other ones. We can't let him know how we brought them in here. I mean, come on. That just ruins the magic. Alright. That is gone. Everything is back the way it was, sorta. Block-wise, at least. These guys should venture quite far. I mean, they're in the trees. They won't go past that. I've showed you them and the rabbits already, which is still kind of annoying me. And there's a rabbit in the vines. anyways. Yeah, and I know they're kind of creeping around where his guardians are a little bit down here every so often. I'm thinking that if he doesn't sign on soon, I will continue doing this. Definitely with the pigs for sure, because you know they're no problem at all. But yeah, as I said, guys, I am going to wrap this up. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Thank you for watching. Feel free to subscribe down below or comment. Let me know what you thought. Give me more ideas of what to do, etc., etc. This has been a really long day for me. But unfortunately, as I said, guys, I do have to go to sleep. So if you liked the episode, feel free to subscribe or comment down below. Give me more ideas of what I can do to make this prank better. And until next time, guys, I will see you later. Have a good one. Bye.